What is going on, everybody? It's your boy Nothing But Skills, and today we're going to be talking about my LMG build that I use for the raid. A lot of you guys have been asking for another build because you guys said that the only reason my AR build works is because I had the Eagle Bearer on there. So I was like, you know what, let me show them my updated 35k damage LMG build. Now this build is a beast, and in the raid it just melts. I really like running it at 35k. And that's not even including any of the damage to elites, because remember, that doesn't show up on the damage. So this military M60 comes with 35.3k base damage, 135 mag size, and it has unhinged on here. So we have receive 20% weapon damage at the cost of negative 25% weapon handling. We have jazz hands, 10% reload speed, and then we have Zen on here, which I don't really care for. So put whatever bottom talent you want on here. Now the way I have this modded, I'm running an 8% damage to elite hollow sight. I'm running a large pouch with plus 35 rounds. I'm also running a 10% accuracy vertical grip and a 5% damage to elite's muzzle brake. Now for my secondary, I'm running another black market. It shows 37.6k, but that's just, I believe that's with unhinged when you have another weapon equipped. It's like a glitch. So when I click it, it's really only 33.9. And then this one's 35.3. So if you look at this, look, when I equip this one, look how this one jumps up to 39.3. So I'm not sure if that's with unhinged active. It kind of shows it, but we're going to click on it. So we're at 33.9K. So at 34K with my second black market, this has 135 rounds. Remember, the great thing about LMGs is they get that 15% damage to targets out of cover. This also has unhinged. So just like the previous military M60, but this one comes with Allegro, so the rate of fire is 50 faster, so it has a rate of fire of 550. Now, the bottom talent's Everlasting. While holstered and in cover, the weapon regenerates 2 ammo every 5 seconds. Not a bad talent, nothing I'm too impressed about. And I also have this modded the same way. The 8% damage to elites, the 35 rounds, the 10% stability, and then the 5% damage to elites. Now, the reason why I am not using my Nemesis, because I don't want you guys to have to use a build that needs an exotic. Honestly, would I use it? Yes. So I'll probably swap out this M60 right here. I would keep my strongest one, right? The one that's at 35K. I will swap out this M60. I would put the Nemesis on, because the Nemesis gives you that while holster gain 25% headshot damage when scoped with your current weapon. And then I would just take off this 8% and then put this 5%. So this scope right here allows me to not have to scope in, but I still get that extra 25% headshot damage. So that's how I would run that, but I'm not. So I'm gonna actually put this M60 back on. So we have 35k on this one, and then on the black market we have 33k. For your pistol, I usually run the shotgun. I like it because it gives me premeditated on here. So if I need to get a quick shot off on Buddy and Lucy on an NPC premeditated, I shoot 2 shotgun shells, I shoot again, and this weapon damage increase for every shell loaded to a max of 35%, and you just have to have 4 or less skill power. Now, the bottom talent is why I really like it. While holster, reloading from empty gives you 20% of your magazine back as free ammo, so you run out of ammo a little bit less, but this only occurs every 30 seconds. So that's how I have my weapon set up. 2 LMGs, and then I have the double barrel shotgun. So if we get into My mask is where you guys are going to get the most of your damage to elites. These can go up to 55% damage to elite rolls. Mine's at 42% right here. So I have the Murakami, gives me 8% health. I do have 8,000 health on here. I have 42% damage to elites, and then I have 10% damage to elites on here. So 52% just on the mask. For the chest, this is probably one of my best chest pieces that I've gotten. It's a Petrov chest. It gives me 10% LMG damage. It gives me 310 skill power, it gives me 8.5% headshot damage, it gives me 17k armor, and then it gives me 10% weapon damage. If I tried to roll any higher weapon damage on here, it would cap out at 12.5%, so I could get an additional 2.5% weapon damage, but I don't want to waste my, I have a couple 13 and 13.5% weapon damage rolls, so I don't want to waste them when this caps out at 12.5. So this one could go up to 12.5, so I could get a little bit more damage. I run Unbreakable in the raid. 70% of max armor is repaired when your armor is depleted. Armor kits used within the next 7 seconds are not consumed, so you need 11 or more defensive. You can see I'm running 6 offensive, 11 defensive, and 2 utility. And then I have a utility mod slot that's giving me 165 skill power. If we get into the holster, this is the holster that I wish I could change out. I wouldn't mind any holster that doesn't have an assault rifle, because I'm not using an assault rifle on here. So this gives me 10% assault rifle damage. It gives me 20k health. That's why I like it. It gives me 10k health on kill, but I'm really running it for the hard hitting. I haven't got another holster with two blues and hard hitting. I would really like anything with two blues and hard hitting over the 10% assault rifle, because I'm not going to run an AR with this particular build. If we get into the knee pads are going to let me unlock that 5% total armor. So Gilligard, I always recommend, if you're going to only run one piece of anything, you want that 5% total armor from Gilligard and an 8% from Murakami. I have armor on here because I want to stack a little bit more armor versus health. You could put health on here if you feel like that's how you play better, but of course armor is better. Patience, after being in cover for 5 seconds, armor repairs 5% every 1 second. So patience is really good. I like it, and I like running this one. One defensive protocol and then one defensive system. So I have the mending on here that's giving me 1800 armor plus that 3.5% total armor, then 2900 armor on kill, and then I have that 6000 health. Now if we go into the gloves, these gloves give me 10% skill power on top of the skill power I have. My skill power is pretty low, so it's kind of a waste, but it has the rolls I need. It had a red roll, a blue roll, and then the damage to elites. So I was able to roll 11% LMG damage, almost maxed out, and then I got 5k health, and then I get that 10% damage to elites. So we get into the backpack, another one of my favorite pieces. The Badger Tough is a pretty good backpack to get if you can get some high rolls, because it has so many blues. It has usually a red, just depends on how it rolls. But you don't have to worry about a talent because you get the damage to elites. So you get that 7% damage to elites. And since I'm running 6 offenses, 11 defensive, there's not too many talents that I can run. And I could have one that has 10% damage to elites on there. But with Badger Tough, you don't get a talent, but you get that 7% damage to elites. So if I'm only going to run one Badger Tough piece, if I put it on the backpack, it works out for me. So I'm only really losing 3% damage to elites. Now my health is 7k on here. I also have 6.5 total armor. I have 8.5 weapon damage. I think this can roll up to 11%, but I don't have anything higher than 8.5. And then I have almost 12k armor right there. And then it comes with an offensive system mod slot that gives me 4% LMG damage and an additional 1.5% weapon damage. Plus I get 3% pistol damage. So if you look, my armor is 262k with this build, 80k health, and then 522 skill power. Now I don't have any mods that are that low. If I could get some low level skill mods, then maybe I could unlock another shot, but I don't, so my mods don't matter. I do run the chem launcher and the reviver hive when I'm in the raid, and I recommend everybody to be doing that. So let's check out the stats. So if we head to the stats, it shows the weapon damage is 35k, the crit chance is 0%, crit damage 25%, so it doesn't matter there. But look, I have 75% headshot damage. Now that's what I'm saying, if I use the Nemesis with this build, I would get additional 25%. So that's gonna push me to about 100% headshot damage. And then imagine if I use the sharpshooter specialization. That would be pretty cool, at least for this patch. In title update 4, that's gonna change a little bit. Then we have the reload speed of 10%, accuracy of 10%, all weapon damage 40%, that's with unhinged guys, 40% LMG damage, and then 92% damage to elites. So that's where you're getting a lot of your damage. 40% all weapon damage, 40% LMG damage, 92% LMG damage. So that's a total of 80% extra weapon damage, right? And then you have your 92% damage to elites. That's why this build does really well. The armor's at 262, 80k health. I have zero hazard protection on here, but I do have some 20% burn resistance. I do run the demolition specialization. Now this is gonna give me the 15% extra LMG damage. If you guys want to be a little bit more accurate and have a little bit less LMG damage, I would recommend sharpshooter. So let's look at the difference of the two. So with sharpshooter on, if I had sharpshooter on, my damage is gonna drop to 32.4K. So I lose 3K damage, right, on my LMG, but I'm gonna gain headshot damage. So just by running that, look at my headshot damage is gonna go up to almost 100%. Now, if I use the Nemesis with that, I'll be at 125%. So that's the difference between it. You lose a little bit of weapon damage, but you gain some headshot damage. You also gain reload speed, so I'll be at 40% reload speed bonus. So it makes a difference, so you can not have to worry about running two LMGs. You have the accuracy, you have the stability. There's a lot of benefits to running the sharpshooter specialization. And that's why a lot of people choose to run the sharpshooter specialization, because of 30% increased weapon stability, reduced recoil, faster reacquisition of targets. You also have 30% increased reload speed, and you have that 25% increased headshot damage. Now, if you just want to have more damage and you're not really worrying about that and you're just running two LMGs, well, that's up to you. So if we look at this one, Now I'm running at 35k base damage. So, but of course, the headshot damage goes down, the stability goes down, the reload speed goes down. So it really just depends on your playstyle. If you want to run two LMGs, I think the Demolitionist isn't too bad. And I do love this talent right here, Crisis Response. When armor is reduced to zero, refills all main weapon. So that's a benefit, right? That's a benefit of losing your armor and being able to reload your two LMGs. So one of my LMGs is at 35K. The other one is at almost 34K. So if we go to the range and we check out the sharpshooter specialization with this LMG. Look, if I'm scoped in, 157K. If I'm not scoped in, 157K. To the body, it's gonna be 70K, but to the head is where you're gonna excel with this build. 157K. Now, it's easier to control than using the other LMG that you saw before. I just wanted to give you guys two options on running it, Demolitionist versus the sharpshooter. It's really up to you. But at the end of the day, it's really running 6, 11, 2, 262k armor, 80k health, and 522 skill power. Let me know if you guys have any questions. I hope this build helps you guys out. I appreciate all the support. And I'm just trying to make more builds for you guys to make it a little bit easier to get to the raid. I'm going to be dropping some easy tutorial guides for every single boss. I already put one out for the last boss, but I had a lot of people still struggling on the first, second, and third boss. And I felt like, you know what, let me just put out some easy guides for you. Also, if you want to go to my Discord, you can find that in the description. There's a lot of people in there looking for groups. We just had a lot of people join. I think we're at about 1,000 members. People trying to get in there, trying to do the raid, trying to complete it, hopefully get a good weapon. Let me know what you guys think. Until the next video, nothing but skills.